Joe Biden cares only about enriching his own family. I care about enriching your family and you. I will be retiring the name Crooked from Hillary Clinton and her moniker. I'm going to retire the name Crooked so that we can use the name for Joe Biden, because he'll be known from now on as Crooked Joe Biden.
That was former President Donald Trump announcing his new nickname for President Biden yesterday during his New Hampshire campaign rally. A new Harvard Caps Harris poll finds a majority, 56% of voters, believe that the Biden family received millions of dollars from sources linked to the Chinese Communist Party. 44% believe they did not. Kelly O'Grady, your reaction.
Well, this is one of my favorite parts of election season. The nicknames that come out of this are always entertaining. And so I think, yeah, we saw that Crooked Hillary worked well. And so this is a smart tactic, I think, for former President Trump to take. You see President Biden not polling well on the economy. So now you start to introduce this question for voters, make them ask themselves, well, does he even have integrity? Is his family receiving money from China? You know, especially as we've been talking about all morning, they're becoming an increasingly bigger threat. So I like the strategy from President Trump and the nickname. It's fun.
Well, you know what, John? We now know that the House Oversight Committee has gone to the Treasury, has viewed the bank records that they have been subpoenaing, and they have reported that there were tens of millions of dollars that the Biden family has taken in from Communist China. And we also know, because James Comer told me last week on Sunday Morning Futures, that he is probing six specific decisions that Joe Biden made as potentially the reason that he was paid that money. Six decisions that he worked with Chinese regulators to implement new rules. So, hey, if the shoe fits, wear it.
That's exactly right. American voters should realize that the Chinese government has invested millions of dollars in Joe Biden, and the Chinese government will see to it that they get a positive return from this investment. There's a close linkage between China and Biden. Voters, beware.
Yeah, well, look, we're going to keep watching this story, obviously, because there's more to come. James Comer told me he thinks it's 12 family members of the Biden family that have actually been part of receiving money from LLCs, which received money from the Chinese Communist Party. We'll see this as a major election theme in 2024. Now we understand South Carolina GOP Senator Tim Scott is going to be making his 2024 presidential run official by the end of next month. Scott announced an exploratory committee earlier this month, you know. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis is also expected to enter this race next month. So, Kelly, things are about to expand. Donald Trump is now solidly on the lead in terms of the primaries. We'll see if anything changes in the coming months with Tim Scott and Ron DeSantis joining the race.
Well, that's right. I'm sure we'll see more nicknames, Maria, for his challengers. But something about Tim Scott, you know, he's really going on a kill him with kindness campaign. I almost feel like it's very much I'm not Trump, you know, very much I'm not going to go negative. I've noticed on some of his campaign stops, he's not, though, answering questions about what restrictions on abortion that he would support. He's being very vague. So when he does, if he does jump in next month, he's going to have to be a lot more clear about what he stands for versus what he's not.
Yeah, at this point, I want to see what all of these candidates' plans are to tackle corruption. John, that's all that matters to so many people right now, because we've seen two systems of justice, two applications of the law. What is Ron DeSantis going to do? What is Tim Scott going to do to ensure to put a check on this corruption in plain sight?
First thing you got to, yeah, exactly. You have to assure a level of a playing field. I mean, if you tolerate corruption by one group of people and on the other hand, you're very much against it if somebody else is corrupt, I think what you're doing is you're reducing confidence. You're diminishing confidence in the law. And without respect for the law in this country, this democracy falls apart very quickly. In addition to corruption, I think it's critically important that the candidate impresses voters that indeed they are going to be competent. And my impression is that the current administration is the height of incompetence. That's how we got into trouble with inflation. And that's why soon we're going to be suffering from a recession.